to teach you two words.
Moram da vas naučim dve reči.
The one is genotype, the other one is phenotype.
Jedan je genotip, drugi je fenotip.
Genotype is the genes that are present in your original cell that you get from mom and dad.
Genotip su svi geni koji su prisutni u zigotu, to jest u oplođenoj jajnoj ćeliji iz koje smo svi nastali.
And phenotype is the result thereof, the expression thereof.
A fenotip je rezultat svih tih gena, znači ono što dobijamo, jedinku kakvu vidite.
So when you look at my translator over
here, znači kada pogledate u njegovog prevodioca ovde,
what do you see?
Šta vidite? Genotip ili fenotip?
It's good that you defined that they could have come up with anything, right? You see phenotype.
Znači vidite fenotip. Kaže, dobro sam rekla genotip ili fenotip.
You don't see the genotype.
Ne vidite genotip.
Of course the genotype is there.
Ali genotip je tu.
But now there's a law in evolution which says,
ali postoji zakon, evolucioni zakon koji kaže,
that natural selection can of course only operate at the level of the phenotype and not the level of the genotype.
Da prirodna selekcija može da deluje samo na nivou fenotipa, a ne na nivou genotipa.
That means that what happens at the level of the genotype happens by chance.
Što znači da ono što se dešava na nivou genotipa dešava se po principu slučajnosti.
By mutation.
Mutacijama.
Example.
Primer.
Two people.
Dva čoveka.
Walking in a national game park.
Šetaju u nacionalnom parku gde ima i divljači.
The one short and fat.
Jedan mali debeli.
The other one lean and mean, like me, for example.
Jedan ovako visok i zgodan kao ja, recimo.
And we're walking in the park.
I šetamo mi nacionalnim parkom negde u safari.
And a lion comes out of the bush.
I iz grma istrčava lav.
And we go,
i on izažde.
Which one is more likely to become the meal of the lion?
Koji je verovatnije da će postati lavov obrok?
The short fat one.
Mali debeli.
So the moral of the story is,
dakle, šta hoću da kažem ovom pričom?
That if you go walking in a game park,
ako šetate, znači, park, nacionalnim parkom, gde
always
ima divljači,
take someone short and fat with you.
Uvek povedite nekog manjeg i debljeg.
So let's think about this.
Da promislimo o ovome.
The phenotype of the one is that he had short little legs and a round little body.
Fenotip onoga koji ima kratke noge i zaokruženo telo.
And the phenotype of the other one that his legs were longer and faster and all kinds of things.
I fenotip ovog drugog koji je bio dugonog i brži shodno tome.
The lion is not worried about the genotype.
Lava baš briga o genotipu obojice.
You understand the way it works now? So natural selection only operates at the level of the phenotype, never the level of the genotype. That's
znači,
a law.
Znači, shvatate šta hoću da kažem. Ovaj zakon kaže da prirodna selekcija uvek deluje na nivou genotipa, fenotipa, a nikad na nivou genotipa.
So here you have your genes, that's your genotype.
Dakle, imate ovde vaše gene, to je vaš genotip.
And those genes that are expressed to make the phenotype, those are subject to natural selection.
A oni geni koji su se eksprimirali i formirali fenotip, oni su podložni delovanju prirodne selekcije.
Everybody understand that now?
Da li svi sad razumete to?
Good, let's continue.
Super, da nastavimo.
So, let's make this practical.
Da to prenesemo u praksu.
I have a book with instructions on how to build an aeroplane.
Imam knjigu sa uputstvima kako da napravim avion.
And I can build the aeroplane from those instructions. There it is.
Po tim informacijama mogu da konstruišem avion.
How do I know how well the aeroplane flies?
Kako znam koliko dobro ovaj avion leti?
I have to build the aeroplane.
Moram zapravo da ga napravim prvo.
Then I get a nutcase to come and sit in it called a test pilot and he flies it.
Onda imam test pilota koji će da sedne i da ga isproba.
You have to pay him lots of money because he doesn't know if it's going to fly so well, right?
A treba prilično platiti ovom test pilotu jer ne znate da li će avion zapravo dobro da leti.
So now, the book of instructions is the same as the genotype.
Ova knjiga sa uputstvima je isto što I naš genotip.
And I will only know if it flies very well once I have created the phenotype.
A kako on leti, znaću jednom kada načinim zaista ovaj fenotip.
So natural selection, I choose it, I keep it, or I discard it, it goes extinct.
Prirodna selekcija kaže, znači, ili ću zadržati ovo, ili ću ga odseći prosto da nije više funkcionalan, znači razni tipovi aviona.
I have a question for you.
Imam pitanje.
Who wrote the book?
Ko je napisao knjigu sa uputstvima?
Ah, somebody intelligent must have written the book, right?
Pa neko inteligentan je morao to biti.
Somebody wrote the book.
Neko je napisao knjigu.
So, in Darwinism,
kod darvinizma,
who wrote the book? That's your DNA. Who wrote it?
Ko je napisao knjigu DNK po darvinizmu?
It's genotype. Who wrote it?
Tu je genotip. Koga je napisao?
I'll tell you who wrote it. Chance wrote it.
Charles ga je napisao.
Chance.
Chance, izvinite, nije Charles, nego...
Not Charles, no, Charles couldn't write it. Chance wrote it. Okay, now, next
Darwina.
Question.
Znači, slučaj je napisao po darvinizmu, darvinističkoj teoriji, slučaj je taj koji je dao informacije, genotip.
Wonderful, Chance wrote the book.
Super, slučajno je nastala knjiga.
The probability is enormous, but Chance did it.
Verovatnoća je neverovatna, ali slučaj je to ipak izveo.
I have a book.
Dakle, knjiga postoji.
It tells me how to build an aeroplane.
I ona mi kaže kako da izgradim ovaj avion.
That's wonderful.
Pa to je fenomenalno.
Now I can finally get an aeroplane.
Napokon mogu da imam avion.
So I put the book down.
Dakle, uzmem knjigu, stavim je.
And I get a chair and I sit down.
Sednem na stolicu.
And I wait for the aeroplane to appear.
I čekam da se avion pojavi.
After all, I've got a book with all the information about an aeroplane.
Pa čekajte, imam knjigu sa svim informacijama kako da nastane avion.
How long am I going to wait?
I koliko dugo ću čekati? Until the next chance.
Forever.
Za uvek.
It's not enough to have a book.
Nije dovoljno imati knjigu.
You see, these genes must be expressed.
Znate, ovi geni moraju da se eksprimiraju.
And it's very precise. I use certain pieces and slice them together. It's incredibly complicated.
Ta ekspresija gene je neverovatno komplikovana. Zapravo treba da slažete delove DNK koji su razdvojeni.
And then I have a script writer who writes them for me on another piece of paper called mRNA.
I onda imam jednog prepisivača koji prepisuje informaciju sa DNK na takozvanu informacionu RNK.
Then I take that and I put it into a machine.
Onda uzimam tu RNK I stavljam je u mašinu koja se zove ribozom.
And I have lots of enzymes.
I imam tu puno enzima
who then build my aeroplane.
Koji onda grade moj avion.
And now I want to ask you, how did the whole system of translating come into existence?
A kako je postao ceo ovaj sistem za prevođenje genetičke informacije iz DNK?
Natural selection cannot help.
Prirodna selekcija tu ne može da pomogne.
Natural selection can only tell me my aeroplane flies or it does not fly.
Prirodna selekcija može samo mi kaže da moj avion leti, upotrebljiv je ili ne leti I znači.
So until I have an aeroplane, forget it.
Dok nemam avion, zaboravite. Zaboravite delovanje prirodne selekcije.
Who built the factory?
Ko je kupio fabriku na
prirodnu? That works so precisely. Who built it?
Ko je stvorio, zapravo izgradio fabriku koja tako precizno funkcioniše?
It's you tell me.
Vi mi kažete.
Yes, chance built it. You're right.
Da, slučaj.
Let me be so cheeky as to introduce another possibility now.
Da budem dovoljno slobodan da još jednu mogućnost iznesem.
What about design?
A šta o dizajnu, šta o
So now you can choose between believing.
Sada možete da izaberete između verovanja.
Boom! 50 New York cities.
Eksplozija I 15 New Yorka izgrađenih u eksploziji.
With all the escalators and everything working perfectly.
Sa svim onim pokretnim stepenicama koje funkcionišu u zgradama.
Or you can believe design. One of the two.
Ili možete verovati u stvaranje po ideji, inteligentno stvaranje.
Now, what if I'm a designer and I want to write some changes into my DNA?
Šta ako imam dizajnera i želim da napravim neke promene u DNK?
Or I'm chance and I want to change the DNA.
Ili imam slučaj, hoću da promenim DNK.
Then that would be called a mutation.
Onda bih to nazvao mutacijama.
He's got nothing to do with mutations. He's just there to be cute.
On nema ništa zajedničko s mutacijama, on je tu samo bude sladak.
So I can change through point mutations or all kinds of different mutations.
I mogu da prođem s vama kroz tačkaste mutacije i sve druge vrste mutacija.
And because we're working with triplet codes,
a budući da radimo sa tripletnim kodovima,
and the enzyme always reads in a particular direction,
a enzim uvek čita DNK u specifičnom pravcu, smeru,
I could, for example, add a nucleotide,
mogu mutacijom recimo da dodam nukleotid,
or I could take one away,
ili da neki izbrišem.
And when I do that, the whole sentence changes.
A kada to uradim, cela rečenica se menja.
So if I add one,
tako da ukoliko dodam jedno slovo,
over there,
jedan nukleotid i ovde,
then the next one would be instead of GGC would be AGG.
I umesto GGC sljedeći bi bio AGG.
And all the subsequent ones would change as well.
I svi sljedeći bi shodno tome bili promijenjeni.
So that's a mutation.
To je mutacija.
By chance.
Slučajna mutacija.
It can happen.
I ona može da se dogodi.
Let's make that simple.
Da stvar učinim jednostavnijom.
Here's a triplet code, the cat and the hat.
Evo jednog tripletskog koda, znači rečenica od reči koje se sastoje od tri slova. Mačka i šešir.
And I'm going to remove the C.
I ukoliko se desi mutacija, skloni se C.
Then my sentence will read the.
Onda bi moja rečenica imala samo član, the.
Ata. Hendete he at.
Onda bi znači umjesto the cat and the hat imali the ata ndt he at.
Rubbish.
Đubre, neupotrebljivo.
So that's why mutations are harmful.
Stoga su mutacije štetne.
And this is not a mutation, he's just cute again.
I ovo isto nije mutacija, to je samo simpatična živuljka.
All right, so rewriting is not such a good idea.
Dakle, prepisivanje nije tako dobra ideja.
Rewriting. The DNA is not such a good idea.
Znači, prepisivanje DNK ili pravljanje izmjena u DNK nije baš dobra ideja.
So now let's see how science tells us how we came into existence.
Da vidimo opet kako nam nauka kaže da smo postali.
So they say first single-celled organisms came together.
Prvo su se formirali su se jednoćelijski organizmi.
But I don't just consist of one cell, I consist of thousands of different cells.
Ali ja se ne sastojim od jedne ćelije, već od hiljada različitih vrsta ćelija.
So Haeckel said, I've got the answer.
I Haeckel kaže, imam ja odgovor.
He said, well, you had one cell, and that cell, when it divided at some stage, stuck together.
Imali ste, kaže, jednu ćeliju i onda se u nekom slučaju, nakon ćelijske deobe, te ćelije su ostale zajedno.
And then it made a ball of cells.
Onda se stvorila cela lopta ćelija.
And then because it swam, it got a dent in the one side.
I onda budući da je bila sve više rasla, onda se došlo do uvlačenja.
And eventually the dent went all the way through.
I onda je došlo do prosto spajanja ta dva sloja.
And that's the basis for you and me.
I to je osnova vas i mene.
We look like that with a dent all the way through.
Mi izgledamo tako.
The one opening for the dent is over here. Ha!
Jedno to udubljenje je ovde.
And the other one I leave to your imagination.
A drugi otvor ću prepustiti vama da zamislite gde je.
And then he said, all the embryos of the various animals testify that we had a common ancestor.
Zatim je zaključio da svi embrioni različitih vrsta životinja prilično liče i prolaze kroz iste stadijume.
Of course he cheated liberally and changed his drawings to suit his theory.
Naravno, namjerno je varao i crteže embrionalnih stadijuma je malko modifikovao da bi odgovarali njegovoj teoriji.
But let's not get nasty and forget his cheating.
Ajde da zanemarimo da je varao.
And let's think about how we became multicellular.
I da razmotrimo kako smo mi to postali višećelijski.
So now let's introduce the genetics.
Hajde sad uvedemo genetiku.
There's the one cell.
Evo jedna ćelija.
If it mutates, we could have a different cell.
Ukoliko ona mutira, možemo imati nešto različitu ćeliju.
That's possible.
To je moguće.
But that's not what we want.
Ali to nije ono što želimo.
I start off with one cell.
Počinjem sa jednom ćelijom.
With information for that simple cell.
I to sa informacijom za tu jednostavnu ćeliju.
And now I want to become multicellular.
A sad hoću da postanem više ćelijski.
Well, let's talk about two cells. There's a muscle cell.
Hajde da govorimo o dve ćelije.
And there's a nerve cell.
Ćelija mišića i nervna ćelija.
So somehow out of that DNA, two informations must have evolved.
Dakle, od one prve DNK koju smo imali za jednu ćeliju, dva različita seta informacija moramo da dobijemo za ove dve različite ćelije.
Now what does that entail?
Šta nam to kaže?
I have a muscle cell.
Imamo ćeliju mišića.
Let's simplify this down to one gene. Of course, it's much more complicated than that.
Da pojednostavimo da je za njeno kodiranje potrebna jedan gen. Naravno da je to mnogo komplikovanije.
So there's a gene which says you are a muscle cell.
Evo gena koji kaže ti si mišićna ćelija.
And there must be a gene which says you are a nerve cell.
A zatim mora postoji i gen koji će reći ti si nervna ćelija.
Now the first cell, did it have two genes like that or was it only necessary to have the one set of data?
Da li je prva ćelija imala oba gena ili je dovoljno bilo da ima jedan niz podataka, jedan komplet podataka?
What do you say?
Šta kažete, li imala oba ili jedan?
Had one.
Jedan set podataka, jednu vrstu DNK.
Well, where's the other one come from?
A odakle nam onda ovaj drugi?
It's a gene.
Again.
The probability of it coming into existence is at least 10 to the power of 127, probably a lot more than that.
Verovatnoća da on sam postane je 1 prema 10 na 127.
It wasn't there before, now it has to be there.
Pre ga nije bilo, a sad mora da nastane jer tu je.
Where's it come from?
I odakle potiče?
Tell me.
Recite.
Chance or
slučaj ili
design.
Ili design.
You can believe chance, I don't mind.
Možete da verujete da je slučaj, nemam ništa protiv.
But you are believing, boom!
Ali vi verujete Empire u onaj prasak i dobijete Empire State zgradu.
That's what you're believing, but that's not enough.
To je ono u što verujete, ali to nije dovoljno.
If I have a light over there and I have a light over there,
ako imam svetlo i tamo i tamo,
and I want that light off and that light on,
i želim da isključim ono, a da ovo ostane uključeno,
what must I have here somewhere?
Šta moram ovde negde da imam?
How many?
Koliko prekidača?
Two. At least two.
Najmanje dva.
So I can switch it on and off or on and off.
Tako da mogu svako svetlo pojedinačno da uključim i isključim.
Now in my brain.
U mom mozgu.
I've got nerve cells.
Imam nervne ćelije.
In my arm I have got muscle cells.
A u ruci mišićne ćelije.
They have exactly the same DNA.
One imaju identičnu DNK.
But in my brain all the genes for muscle are switched off.
Ali u mom mozgu svi geni koji govore o formiranju mišićne ćelije su isključeni.
And all the genes for nerve cell are switched on.
A uključeni su svi geni za formiranje nervne ćelije.
Now the original cell didn't have two cells.
A prva ćelija od koje smo svi nastali zigot nije bilo dve ćelije. Izvinjavam se, prva ćelija od koje smo nastali.
So it didn't need a switch.
Znači, bila je samo jedna, tako da ju nije trebao prekidač.
But if I want this to work, I need a switch.
Dakle, da bi ovo funkcionisalo, trebaju nam prekidači.
In fact, I need two switches. You're on, you're off. You're on, you're off.
Tačnije dva. Da svakoj kažu, ti si uključen, ti si isključen.
Where's the switch come from?
A odakle potiče prekidač?
It's genotype. It's never subject to natural selection.
To je genotip. I on nikada nije podložen prirodnoj selekciji.
Where's it come from?
Pa odakle potiče?
Hello.
Hello.
Chance or design?
Slučaj ili dizajn, inteligentno stvaranje.
Boom little house, boom little house.
Eksplozija i kuća.
That's what you must believe.
To je ono u što morate verovati.
Okay, so now, how do I switch the one off and the other one on?
Dobro, pa kako onda kada imam prekidače, uključujem, isključujem?
I need a whole set of extra things to switch it on and to switch it off.
Moram imati još ceo set dodatnih sredstava da uključuju i isključuju prekidače.
Just like if I have two switches against the wall there.
Čak i ako imam dva prekidača na zidovima.
And nobody to switch them on and off.
A nema nikoga da ih pali i gasi.
They would be totally useless.
Potpuno su beskorisni.
Where does this complicated mechanism come from? One of the most complicated known to science.
A odakle onda ovaj nauci najkomplikovaniji sistem poznat nauci?
Much more complicated than anything we've ever built, including Challenger rockets that can go into space.
Mnogo, mnogo komplikovanije nego bilo šta što je čovek stvorio i izgradio, rakete, Challengeri.
If you believe in evolution, you have to believe it happened by chance.
Ako verujete u evoluciju, morate verovati da je sve to nastalo slučajno.
Oh, but that's still not enough.
Ali još uvijek nije dovoljno.
What's the point if I have a nerve cell and a muscle cell over here?
I šta da radim ako imam nervnu ćeliju i mišićnu ćeliju svaka na svojem mestu?
No good if I had a nerve cell in here and a muscle cell in here, so what?
I kakvo je mi je korist od njih pojedinačno?
They have to talk to each other.
Moraju komunicirati međusobno.
The nerve cell has to tell the muscle cell.
Nervna ćelija mora reći mišićnoj, hajde sad da se svi aktivirajte.
So what do I need?
Dakle, šta mi treba?
I need structural genes which say you look like this, you look like that.
Trebaju mi strukturni geni koji mi kažu ti ćeš izgledati ovako, a ti ovako.
I need promoter genes which says you switched on, you switched off, you switched off, you switched on.
Trebaju mi promoteri. Geni promoteri koji će govoriti ti si uključen, ti si isključen genima.
I need genes to control the physiology that work totally differently.
Trebaju mi geni koji kontrolišu fiziologiju koji potpuno različito rade.
I need genes to control the embryology so that they start working together and grow together.
Trebaju mi geni koji kontrolišu embrionalni razvoj da bi sve išlo na vreme i kada mu je mesto i vreme.
So Haeckel did an easy thing. He drew two cells tup, tup, next to each other. Finished, done.
Haeckel je jednostavno povezao dve ćelije kada je zamišljao kako su nastali višećelijski organizmi i to je sve.
He had no idea what he was drawing.
On nije imao pojma šta radi zapravo.
Now all these extra genes have to come into operation.
Sad svi ovi dodatni geni treba da uđu u funkciju.
It's genotype, so it's boom little house, 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 boom little house.
Genotipi su tako po njemu, znači bum, pa mala kuća, pa kuća, pa kuća, sve eksplozija.
Wow, now you need extraordinary faith for that.
Za ovo vam stvarno treba neverovatna vera.
But now they've come into existence.
Ali, recimo, došli su i oni u postanje.
And the aeroplanes are there.
I imamo sad sve avione.
The first organisms are there.
Ili prvi organizmi su tu.
Now natural selection can start to work.
I napokon prirodna selekcija može da počne da deluje.
Wonderful, I can start working through natural selection.
Super, mogu da počnem da radim prirodnom selekcijom.
So now if I want to select...
Dakle, ukoliko hoću da izvršim selekciju.
That implies I have how many to select from at least.
To znači da moram da imam najmanje koliko nečega da bih mogao da izaberem.
Dva. Ah, you need two.
Dakle, dva vam treba.
So you have to double up your thinking now.
Treba sad da udvostručite mi razmišljanje.
So natural selection cannot create anything.
Dakle, prirodna selekcija ne može ništa da stvori.
It can only choose between two that are already there.
Ona može samo da izabere između dva već postojeća entiteta.
So natural selection can say, well, which of these two aeroplanes flies best?
Ona samo može da kaže koji od ova dva aviona ima bolje performanse.
And let's say natural selection decides this one flies better.
I ako prirodna selekcija odluči da ovaj bolje leti,
then we say it has a selective advantage.
Onda kažemo da taj ima selektivnu prednost.
And the other one doesn't fly so well.
A drugi baš i ne leti tako dobro.
So according to Darwinism, what eventually happens to the other one?
I po darvinizmu, šta će se napokon desiti ovom prvom?
Ah yes, it goes extinct.
Dakle, biva istrebljen.
That's how natural selection works.
Tako radi prirodna selekcija.
But I want you to think about that.
Ali želim da o tome razmišljate.
In order for natural selection to work, you have to start with at least two.
U cilju da bi da prirodna selekcija počne da radi, morate imati bar dva entiteta.
So once natural selection has worked, how many have you got left?
I kad nakon delovanja prirodne selekcije koliko vam je ostalo?
One.
Jedan.
Oh, but now I have a question for you.
A sad imam pitanje.
If you started with two and you ended with one,
ako ste počeli sa dva, a završavate sa jednim entitetom,
do you now have more or less than you started with?
Jel imate više ili manje od početnog?
Less.
Manje.
Huh? But then how, through natural selection, are we going to get more and more variety?
I kako onda kroz prirodnu selekciju da dobijem sve veći i veći broj varijeteta?
And more different animals?
I sve više različitih životinja.
If all natural selection can do is make less and less.
I ako je sve što prirodna selekcija može da uradi, da smanjuje broj.
Now, I'm not clever enough to work that out.
Još uvijek nisam uspeo da domislim o tome.
I don't know how to get more and more with a mechanism that uses less and less.
Stvarno ne znam kako da dobijam sve više i više od mehanizma koji stalno smanjuje broj.
Oh, well, science has come up with an answer.
Nauka je našla odgovor i na to.
And we'll discuss it in a moment.
I upravo ćemo o tome prodiskutovati.
This is the classic example of the peppered moth.
Ovo je klasični primjer moljca.
Where the dark moth on the light background is at a selective disadvantage.
Gde tamna varijanta iste vrste ima selektivnu ne prednost, nego znači nazadnost u odnosu na onog koji je beo, koji se ne vidi.
And the opposite. On a black background it will have an advantage.
Ono prethodno je bilo na svetloj pozadini, a na tamnoj pozadini je suprotno. Crni ima selektivnu prednost.
If we look at plants for example,
ako pogledate biljke,
we will find for example that leaf shape has declined over time.
Vidimo da se smanjio broj oblika listova tokom vremena.
So natural selection made less and less.
Dakle, prirodna selekcija je sve manje i manje ostavljala proizvoda.
Where do we get all the variety that we have from?
Odakle onda sva varijabilnost koju imamo?
Each gene must have come about by chance or design.
Svaki gen morao je nastati ili slučajno ili inteligentnim dizajnom.
So there is a huge amount of variety built in.
Dakle, mora postojati ogromna varijabilnost koja je već ugrađena.
For example, in the dog you can get from this size to that size and all these shapes and sizes.
Znači, kod pasa možete dobiti sve moguće varijante od ovolišnih do ovolikih.
And it all was in the wild type, in the wolf.
A sve je to bilo u onom primarnom divljem tipu kod vuka.
All these colors.
Sve ove boje.
All these ear shapes.
Svi ovi oblici ušiju.
All those alleles, all those variant genes were in the wolf wild type.
Svi ovi geni i sve ove varijante bile su već urođene u prirodnom tipu, divljem tipu u vuku od koga su psi.
And had to get into there by either chance or design.
I sve to je moralo da bude u vuku ili slučajno ili po inteligentnom dizajnu.
Look at this hair type here. You know, the poodle.
Pogledajte ove vrste krzna.
That's like pudlica. African hair.
To je kao kosa afričkih crnaca.
If we put the Afghan there, we'd have Swedish hair.
Ako pogledate afganistanskog hrta, imat ćete kosu Šveđana.
If we look at these snails over here,
ako pogledate ove puževe,
they were all classified as different species.
Oni su svi bili klasifikovani kao različite vrste.
Today they're all classified as one species.
Danas svi spadaju u jednu vrstu.
Because we know that there are different gene varieties within the same species.
Jer znamo da postoji varijabilnost gena unutar jedne vrste.
These moths have different shapes at different seasons.
Ovi moljci, zapravo leptiri, imaju različite oblike i različito izgledaju u različitim sezonama.
So how much variety within this wild pigeon?
Koliko dakle ima varijeteta u ovom divljem tipu goluba?
So breeders have made giant pigeons, tiny pigeons.
Tako da su selekcionisanjem dobili i ove ogromne i ove male.
And all these funny pigeons in between.
I sve ove smešne golubove između.
Anything from snow walkers to opera singers.
Od ovih operskih do šetača po snegu.
And all those genes must have been built in by chance or by design.
I u divljem tipu svi ti geni morali su biti već ugrađeni slučajno ili inteligentnim dizajnom.
Remember, natural selection can't put them there. Natural selection can't put them there.
A prirodna selekcija nije mogla te gene tamo da stavi.
And all this variety within this beetle?
I sve ove varijante kod buba?
Or that one?
Ili ove?
And now what about this interesting animal called the quahha?
A šta da kažemo o kvahi, ovoj zanimljivoj životinji?
A type of zebra.
Vrsti, jednoj tipu zebre.
And it's extinct.
I on je izumro.
But they had one skin in the museum in Cape Town.
Ali imaju jednu kožu u muzeju u Cape Townu.
And when they looked, there was a blood vessel on the back.
I kada su je analizirali, postoje krvni sud na leđima.
With red blood cells.
Sa crvenim krvnim zrncima.
Wonderful! They sent it to the United States for DNA analysis.
Super, onda su je poslali u Sjedinjene Države da bi izvršili analizu DNK, jer su mogli, imali su krvne ćelije.
And then to their great surprise.
I na njihovo veliko iznenađenje.
The DNA was exactly the same.
DNK je bila identična.
As that of the living plains zebra.
Onih običnih i danas živućih zebri.
So the animal wasn't extinct at all.
Pa znači ova životinja i nije izumrla.
So now they have a breeding program breeding the quahha back.
Znači sad imaju program selekcioniranja i uzgajanja tako da se ponovo dobije ona ova quahha kakva je nekad bila
these
od živih zebri, danas živućih.
These ladybirds were different species in the past.
Ove bubamare su smatrane za različite vrste u prošlosti.
Until they discovered that different genes are activated in the spring or in the winter.
Dok nisu zaključili da se različiti geni aktiviraju u proleće, a različiti u zimu.
And these are one species as well.
A ovo je sve jedna vrsta takođe.
And mice can go white or black depending on the background.
A miševi mogu da budu beli ili crni, zavisno na kakvoj podlozi žive.
So they have two sets of genes.
Dakle, imaju dva seta gena za boju krzna.
The same with rabbits, you know that they can change.
Isto važi i za zečeve, znači, znate da i oni mogu da menjaju
And lizards.
Boju. I za guštere.
So all those genes are either built in by design or by chance.
I da li su svi ti geni ugrađeni tamo slučajno ili inteligentnim
But
dizajnom?
But now science says we must have more variety, otherwise this thing's not going to work.
Jer nauka kaže treba nam više variabilnosti da bi ovo moglo da funkcioniše.
So these modifications in the genotype have to come about by chance now.
Tako da ove modifikacije u genomu morale su da nastanu slučajno.
And science teaches that the way to increase variety is through fertilization.
A nauka kaže da bi se povećala varijabilnost, to se čini oplodnjom.
So this was the most non-pornographic form of this that I could show you.
Ovo je bila najmanje pornografska scena koju sam mogao da pokažem kad je u pitanju parenje.
So this is how science gets more variety.
Ovako nauka dobija veću varijabilnost.
By mixing the genes of the male and the female.
Mešanjem gena mužjaka i ženke.
I have a question for you.
Imam pitanje.
This variety
Ova varijabilnost
will only come into existence
će postati
once the male and the female genes have been mixed.
Samo kada se pomešaju geni mužjaka i ženke.
That means the children will be more varied than in an amoeba, for example.
In amoeba or
the children, you'll have more variety of children from this than from just division like an amoeba.
A dakle, znači dobit ćemo veću varijabilnost kod potomaka polnog paranja nego kod ameba koje se samo dele, razmnožavaju ćelijskom deobom.
Now just shake your heads to wake up again.
Aj malo prodrmajte glavu samo da se razbudite.
Because think about this.
Razmislite o tome.
The children must first be born.
Deca, potomci prvo moraju biti rođeni.
Before natural selection can use the extra variety.
Pre nego što prirodna selekcija može da koristi onu veću varijabilnost, dodatnu varijabilnost.
Are you with me?
Jeste li sa mnom?
So where did male and female come from?
Odakle su onda došli u postanje muško i žensko?
Because it means nothing until they've come together and produced children.
Jer nema ništa, nema povećanja varijabilnosti dok oni ne dođu do parenja i proizvodnje nastanka dece.
Where did it come from?
Odakle je sada to postalo?
You tell me.
Ajde vi mi recite.
You only have two choices.
Imate samo dva izbora.
Chance or
slučaj ili
design.
Zavisnost.
Wow.